So here is the diagram which can gives you idea about what is meant by odogonium, how the thallus having a structure and how it can be fertilized and how the formation of a zygote, and later on that zygote develops into a zoospore and zoospore germinate into a new plant one. So in this way, how whatever the life cycle of a odogonium, we are going to learn about it. So first of all, occurrence of odogonium. So here is the word, that is odogonium, means in Greek odos means a swelling, means a bulk like structure, and gonos means a reproductive body. So that's why odogonium is a freshwater alga. Out of 400 species which are found in all over worldwide area, 200 species have been reported from India, and they are very common in pools, ponds and lake. Then the thallus structure of the odogonium is a long elongated filamentous body which may get attached with the stone, wood, leaves of aquatic plants. Small branches of dead plant remain in water. All are the substratum on which filamentous body of a odogonium or a thallus of a odogonium going to be attached, and that can be attached with the help of basal cell called as holoplast. And some species like Odogonium terrestris are the terrestrial, means a land plant or land alga. So here is the complete filamentous thallus body of an Odogonium, which possesses a basal holoplast, which is a flattened disc like cell, and at the apical region or at the topmost position there is a apical cell which possesses apical caps, and in between apical cell and basal cell there is a presence of a long elongated rectangular cell, that is nothing but a middle cell, which is the most important part of the thallus, and which is also called as a vegetative filament. So this diagrams can reveals two structure. A is nothing but a complete thallus of a odogonium, while B is the vegetative cell. So the plant body of odogonium, that is a thalloid plant body, which is always green in color. Then it is multicellular, means many cells are present over there, and that many cells are continuously attached with each other and forms a filaments. That's why the plant body of odogonium is the filaments and unbranched. So the cells of each filament are attached end to end and form uniseriate row, that is a filamentous structure. The filament is differentiated into three types of cell, that is first one, that is a basal cell, which is also called as a holoplast, then apical cell, which is present at the topmost, and in between both of them there is a presence of middle cell. So these are all rectangular cells, are nothing but a middle cells. While Indian species like Odogonium cardiacum, then Odogonium aster, Odogonium elegans, Odogonium aerolatum and Odogonium armigerum are the common species which are found in Indian regions. Then basal cell, it is the lowermost cell of the filament. The cell is long, gradually narrowed, and present towards the basal end. It expands to form a simple disc like multi-lobed or finger-shaped structures. So in previous diagram, here is the basal holoclast, which is a flattened disc which can develop a projection-like structure which is going to be attached on the substratum. So this basal cell called as a holoclast is the cell generally colorless which performs the function of fixation of the substratum and called as holoclast. So first of all, basal cell is called also called as holoclast. That holoclast is going to be attached at any substratum with the help of a disc like multi-lobe finger shaped structure, and that can always hold together complete thallus of odogonium with a substratum. Then apical cell is the topmost cell of the filament. The cell is usually rounded towards apical side and green in color. So this apical cell present at topmost of the filament and rounded towards apical side and always in green color. Middle cell is the most important complete plant body of a odogonium. So what happened? All the cells in between basal cell and apical cell are alike. Alike means different. The cells are longer than their braid, that is nothing but a rectangular shape, and that rectangular cells are the middle cells. So towards the upper end of some cells, a ring like structure is present known as cap or apical cap. So each and every middle cell possesses a ring like structure which is a cap or apical cap, which can be found in a previous diagram. The cells with a cap is called as a cap cell. The number of caps on cells indicates the number of division in that cells, means a single rectangular cells, suppose it divided four times, so at that time that cell possesses a four cap cells or apical caps. Then important features of odogonium. So odogonium generally, how it is looking like a thallus, and what actually that thallus possesses is nothing but a morphological characteristic. This is a common freshwater alga growing on substratum like sand particles or rocks, means a stony substances. The plant body is unbranched. Why it is unbranched? Because each and every rectangular cell is attached with each other at the end of each and every cell. So that's why there is a development of long elongated filamentous structure which could not possess any branching pattern. That's why the plant body is unbranched, filamentous and differentiated into apex and base. Then cells have reticulated chloroplast. So reticulated means a net like or network like chloroplast, and chloroplast is the most important cell organelle in case of algae, because that algae can develop their own food material with the help of chloroplast, that is nothing but a photosynthesis. So that's why it is the most important cell organelle. Presence of caps on the young dividing cells, that is again a unique characters in case of a odogonium. So this diagram can give you a complete idea about how the cells are present in a odogonium. Then these are the some morphological characteristics which characters are present on odogonium thallus. So the vegetative cell division is very elaborative. A sexual reproduction take place by multiflagellated zoospores, means a thallus structure of odogonium can develop a zoospores which are multiflagellated, and with the help of that zoospore there is a development of new plant body or thallus body. Then sexual reproduction is advanced oogamous type. Then female gamete, that is ovum, is produced singly in each oogonium. So a single rounded swell oogonium can develop just only one ovum. The male gametes, that is anthrozoids, are very much similar to zoospores but smaller in size, and two anthrozoids are produced in each anthridium. Means each anthrozoids are produced within each anthridium. Then based on the size of male filaments, the plants are divided into two groups, that is macrandus and nanandrus. So what happens in case of a macrandus type? The anthridia develop into the filament of normal size, but in nanandrus type the anthridia develop on small and thin male filaments. So that is the most important difference in between macrandus and nanandrus. Then the dwarf male nanandrus is also called as a dwarf male or nanandrium, which remain attached to the oogonium wall or its lower wall, that is a supporting cell to that. Then a development on a germination of androspores that can be developed into a new plantlet. The androspores forms single in androsporangium, which again develop in the normal filaments. So in this way there is a development of new thallus, while the androspores are smaller than zoospores. Androspores are so smaller than zoospores, which are produced asexually, but larger than anthrozoids. The zygotes undergoes meiotic division and produce four zoospores. In case of dioecious species, it produces two male, and other species, monoecious species, produce two female plants. So in this way they can complete their life cycle in overall view. Then come towards the cell structure. There is a most important cell structure, that is a rectangular middle cell, that is the intercalary cell. Means a middle cell which is a rectangular in shape, that is also called as intercalary cells, are longer than their breadth and are cylindrical in outline. Then these cells are surrounded by thick and rigid cell wall. The cell wall is differentiated into three layers: an outer layer, that is chitin. Then below that there is a presence of middle layer called as a pectin, and innermost layer, that is a cellulose. So the cell wall of an intercalary cell or vegetative cell or rectangular cell or a middle cell, that is developed by three layers: outer layer chitin, middle layer pectin, and innermost layer, that is a cellulose. So just interior to the wall, cell membrane is present, which encloses the protoplast. Means inside that three layered cell wall, just next to that there is a presence of protoplast. The protoplast consists of cytoplasm, chloroplast, and nucleus. So in case of a oogonium cell, protoplast is the living in nature, and that is nothing but an cytoplasm with chloroplast and nucleus. The cells contain many small or single large vacuole situated in the center and remain filled with cell sap. As like a plant cell, this oogonium cell also possesses a centrally located single large vacuole which is filled with cell sap, which is a viscous fluid. Then the cytoplasm lies between the cell membrane and vacuole. Means this three-layered cell wall, inside that there is a cell membrane, and inside to that cell membrane there is a presence of protoplast. That protoplast is made up of by the cytoplasm, chloroplast and nucleus. And rather than this complete structure, at the center there is a presence of vacuole. So the vacuole and a cell membrane, in between that gap there is a presence of cytoplasm, or and collectively called as a protoplasm. So the chloroplast is single, large and reticulated. So each cell possesses a single chloroplast, which is a large in size and completely filled with that can occupy a complete cell surface with a reticulated structure, which remains embedded in a cytoplasm, and it extend from one end to other end of the cell, means from top to bottom. Cells are uninucleated, means only one nucleus is present, and in the center of the cell there is a presence of cytoplasm, or it may be a cells are uninucleated and nucleus is generally present in the center of the cell within a cytoplasm, or it may be present at a peripheral site or a eccentric location. So this is all about a cell structure of a middle cell. Then come towards the cell division. So cell division is the most important thing in case of Odobonium, because with the help of cell division growth can be take place. So the growth of the filament, which can be take place through the cell division. All cells except apical cell and basal cell are capable of dividing, means a whole plast and apical cell are not going go under the cell division, while the intercalary or middle cells, which are rectangular in shape, they can divide and redivide and develops a new cell, means they can elongate the filaments. The steps of the cell division are, first of all, it initially initiates with the nucleus, because nucleus is actually take part in the cell division. So nucleus becomes shifted from peripheral position towards the center, means if the nucleus is present near to the peripheral position, and then moves slightly towards the upper half of the cell. After that, ring-like thickenings develops towards the upper part of the cell wall, which gradually increases in thickness. So first of all, that ring-like thickenings develop towards the upper part of the cell wall, which gradually increases the thickness. Then the nucleus undergoes mitotic division and form two nuclei, means that nucleus which is present at a periphery that come toward the center, and after that nucleus can be displaced, them can be divided them into two equal half, and two daughter nuclei are developed. At the end of the cell division, means a telophase, a row of microtubules develop and accumulate as a layer between the daughter nuclei. So after the telophase, there is a development of a row of microtubules, which can develop a septation or a layer in between two daughter nuclei. This layer remains in floating condition, which will develop the future septum. Then the ring-like thickenings gradually elongates and spill the mother wall towards the apical region. The ring expands much more and forms a concave cylindrical structure. So that concave cylindrical structure is a further development, and the ring material ultimately forms the cuticle of the upper daughter cell. So in this way, there is a development of a new daughter cells, and for that purpose, the upper part of the ruptured mother wall remains attached to the anterior end of the new daughter cell as a cap, and in this way there is a development of apical cap. The other part remains towards the basal region of the daughter cell. Then the floating septum gradually goes up to the base of the future daughter cell, that is at the top of the mother cell at the ruptured end, and it becomes fixed. Later on, it develops into mature cross wall, and in this way a new side wall develops between the cuticle and the plasma lemma of the upper cell. Thus the two cells are formed. It is evident that the cell with cap is the younger one, which develops between two old cells. So in this way there is a development of a cap cell, and with the help of how many cap cells are present over there, we can say this cell is divided number of times. So here is the diagram which can reveal how the cell division is going on in case of a Oudogonium. So this figure number 3.73 reveals a initial cell which possesses just a nucleus which come at the central location. Then at the upper part in a figure B, the nucleus is again come towards the actual central location, and there is a development of a ring like structure. Then this nucleus can divided into two equal half, and microtubules are also developed over there. In this way, the microtubule can separate two daughter nuclei, and at the apical region there is a development of new lateral wall, and above that there is a development of first new cap and old cap. In this way, there is a development of two daughter cells. So here is the development of two daughter cells. Within that, one daughter cell, apical daughter cell, is a new daughter cell, and below that there is a pre-existing daughter cells, and when they can attain their complete growth, at that time there is a development of long elongated rectangular daughter cell with mother cell, and in this way there is a development of two cap cells in a new daughter cell, while mother cell possesses only one cap cell, which is shown in a figure 3.72f. that is the successive stages of cell division. In case of a cell division, that is a mitotic type of cell division, and after that the Oudogonium can reproduce them into three types, that is nothing but an a vegetative reproduction, then a sexual type of reproduction, and sexual type of reproduction. So vegetative reproduction, it takes place by the fragmentation and a kinet formation. So first of all, fragmentation means of small fragments develop. So it takes place by the accidental breakage of the filament. Odobonium is a long elongated filamentous thallus body. If that filament is broken down in small pieces, at that time each and every piece can develop into a new thallus body. So that's why it takes place by the accidental breakage of the filament and dying off of intercalary cells. Means even a single intercalary cell is broken down from a thallus body, and a single intercalary cell can develop a new plant thallus, or by the formation of intercalary sporangia. So intercalary cell can also develop a sporangia. That sporangia can develop into a new thallus body. The fragments are capable of developing into a new filament. Means in case of a fragmentation of a odogonium, if the odogonium thallus can broken down into small fragments, so in that case that can be developed into a new filaments. Such capacities are found in each and every fragments. Then a kinetes. During unfavorable condition, the entire protoplast of a cell becomes a thick wall, then reddish brown and round or oval structure. That is the akinete. Means suppose the thallus body didn't get a favorable condition, means they didn't get a nutrition or a shelter at that time, they can develop them into a akinetes. That is nothing but a thick wall, reddish brown color, round or oval structure. That is called as a akinete. That akinete germinates during when it gets a favorable condition and develops a new filament. They are generally formed in a chain. Means akinete can form a long elongated chain with a reddish brown round oval structure akinetes. Then a sexual type of reproduction that can be take place by means of development of a zoospores, which can be shown in a diagram 3.74 A to C. Zoospores are formed singly within a cell. Comparatively younger cells, that is the cell with caps, behave as a sporangium mother cell. Means a rectangular cell which has a cap cells, that cell can develop a sporangium, and that's why it is called as a sporangium mother cell. The zoospores are multiflagellated, ovoid, pyriform or spherical in shape. Means oval or long, pyriform or spherical in shape. They are uninucleate with a single chloroplast and occasionally with a small minute eye spot. So here is the diagram which can shows a sexual reproduction. So this is a long elongated rectangular intercalary cell with a cap cell. So that cap cell which possesses a cap cell, that cell can become a zoosporangia mother cell and develops into a zoosporangium. So this is a diagram B which shows a three caps and zoosporangium. That zoosporangium having a slight bend, a concave shape at the time of developing condition, and if it attains a maturity at that time, it can be formed into a unequal single spherical structure. So here is the C diagram which can shown that structure, and that complete sporangium is enclosed within a mucilage sheath, and when it attains a further maturity at that time, it develops into a numerous small flagella. So the diagram D shows a zoospores which possesses a flagella. Then within a diagram A, Here is the zoospores which are get liberated from a sporangia mother cell and freely float in a water. If they got any substratum at that time, they can attach on that substratum and directly germinate into a new plant body as shown in a diagram G. So this diagram G shows a basal cell which is a long elongated finger like projection which can hold the substratum, and above body which is after that going to be divided into a basal cell, whole flask, apical cell and intercalary middle cell, that is a rectangular cell. So in this way there is a successive stages of zoospore formation in case of a Odogonium. So what happen after that? If they get a favorable condition, zoospore formation begins in a capsule of the filament. The entire protoplast of a zoosporangium contracts, form the wall and behave as a unit. The protoplast becomes round or oval in shape and its nucleus move at the one end. Near the nucleus, a semicircular hyaline area is developed. Just below the hyaline area, there is a ring of blepharoplast granules develops and connected with each other by a fibrous strand. So in this way there is a development of a zoosporangium. Later on, from each blepharoplast granule single flagellum develops. Thus a crown of flagella is present around the each and every colorless semicircular area. The fully developed zoospores are liberated by breaking zoosporangium wall. The wall of zoosporangium break near the cap region and the neighboring cell bend on one side to make a way for the liberation of a zoospore. So what happened in this? The breakage of a sporangium wall, and after that the zoospores come outside that and liberated into a atmosphere. During that liberation, the zoospores remains as a delicate mucilage vesicle which can still having for a 3 to 10 minutes. After that they can dissolve. The vesicles of the zoospores get free and start swimming in the surrounding water. So when they get swimming, when they swim in a surrounding water, at that time germination process going to be start, because they imbibe the water. The zoospore can swim for about 1 hour or more. At that time they can come in contact with a substratum by the anterior end, and it loses their flagella and start to elongate. And in this condition they are going to attend their growth, means a germination. So the lower hyaline part becomes separated by cell wall, means a lower hyaline surface which holds the substratum, that becomes a colorless and which forms into a whole flask. Through the subsequent division and redivision, a single plane, a new filament is formed. Means what happened? If the zoospores attach on a substratum, at that time they loses their flagella and they start to elongate first of all. Then they hold the substratum, and the basal part or lower part of the zoospore becomes a colorless and behave as like a whole flask. The subsequent portion of that cell or zoospore is going to be divide and redivide in a single plane, and new filament is formed. In this way there is a sexual asexual type of reproduction is going to be happen, and here we are going to stop. And further sexual type of reproduction we can learn in a next lecture. So here is many more diagrams, and whatever the description is regarded with a sexual type of reproduction, we can continue in a next lecture. Till then, you have to see this, read this carefully, and next time we know about life cycle of a Odogonium.